Calypso legend David Rudder has been diagnosed with Parkinson's disease and as a result is expected to be performing on stage for the last time in a major show next month. Rudder, affectionately known as King David, turned 70 on May 6. And on that day, he will be marking the occasion with an event entitled Come and Celebrate at Soundforge in Woodbrook. But the performance may be bittersweet, as it is anticipated to be his last time on a major stage. Speaking during a press conference at the Kaiser Blues Cafe a short while ago, Rudder said after the pandemic and the loss of several loved ones, he decided to do a health checkup. This is when he said he discovered that he had Parkinson's disease, and while he may do other performances, this is expected to be the last of this magnitude. Chief Secretary of the Tobago House of Assembly, Farley Augustine, says citizens must bend their knee in the stance against crime. He made the comment on Thursday during Gospel Night, the first event to kickstart the Tobago Jazz Experience at the Shore Park Complex. Farley said prayer remained critical in response to growing crime and violence. The THA Chief Secretary's comment comes just days after a two-day CARICOM Crime Symposium concluded, with regional leaders moving towards banning the public's use of assault weapons.
At a time when we are grappling with several social issues, the levels of criminality are through the roof. We see what's happening with our young people. We see that they are often selecting negative vices as opposed to those that are positive. And I'm saying that the war that we have to fight on all fronts may not require us to spend more monies on police cars or guns or more monies on cameras, but it requires us to spend more time on our knees.
Thursday's gospel concert saw artists such as Jared Nurse, Chantal Lindsay, Positive, and Pastor Terrence Bynes, who belted out tunes that shook the crowd, many of whom were swaying their shoulders and clapping along in a worship session that filled the entire Shore Park Complex auditorium. The United States says it is committed to working with the government to fight violent crime. In response to questions from Guardian Media, a spokesperson for the U.S. Embassy said the Embassy of the United States of America continues to work with and provide significant security assistance to the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service and other national security agencies to support efforts to address the root causes of crime and violence and improve citizen security. The statement continued, as a top priority by Caribbean partners in the May 2020 Caribbean-U.S. Security Cooperation Dialogue. U.S. security assistance through the Caribbean Basin Security Initiative includes building regional capacity to disrupt illicit firearms trafficking. The spokesperson also noted the U.S. State Department's March statement on U.S.-Caribbean cooperation to stop firearms trafficking. But some regional experts are not hopeful that the two-day crime symposium among leaders will bear any fruit. The symposium to address crime and violence as a public health issue ended on Tuesday, with CARICOM coming together to register its grave concern at the increased illegal importation of guns from the USA. They are now declaring a war on guns. But one former Minister of National Security in St. Kitts and Nevis says regional talk shops are typically ineffective.
But this thing is not just about banning assault rifles. That's important. It's about changing people, changing institutions. It's about removing corruption in high office, because a lot of the criminality gets treated with a blind eye by people who can make decisions to stop it.
Now, as Stefan was a national security minister from 2004 to 2008, now St. Lucia has experienced a recent increase in gun violence that has resulted in the deaths of family members or suspected gang members, including a young child. Felicia Dujon is a St. Lucian human rights advocate based in Barbados, and she says regional governments have to understand that crime prevention requires a holistic approach.
They're not looking in terms of rehabilitative ways of shaping the minds of young persons. It's more punitive. Okay, a young person does something, let's just punish them. And so when we have that kind of attitude, and I think that attitude is generational, because it's only a group of persons that still believe that the more punishment that we give people is the more that they perhaps will deter them. So it's we as a society have to restructure the way that we think.
You're watching the Midday News here on CNC3. Time now for a short break.
New specs, new vision at Seaview Optical. Get single vision clear lenses in frame $299. Bifocal clear lenses in frame $399. Single vision transition lenses in frame just $999. So much more offers in store. Only at Seaview Optical. Affordable eye care for everyone.
The Premier League on C-Sport just got better. Win your share of up to $15,000 when you play CPIC. Predict the winning teams, final scores, and score difference, and a piece of the pie could be yours. Compete for the title of CPIC champion and put your Premier League knowledge to the test. With millions up for grabs, top the table and take home the cash. Visit csport.win today and log your predictions. C-Sport, the best way to see sports.
On this episode of Caribbean Passport, explore the world of customer service excellence, elevate your hairstyle with Jamal Edmonds, and join us in Jamaica at Emancipation Park. All this and more. It's Caribbean Passport, this Sunday at 7:30 p.m. on CNC3.
Ncash is a mobile wallet that gives users the convenience of making digital payments. You can use Ncash with any local debit card or credit card to pay anyone and or any business on Ncash, no matter who they bank with. It's as easy as scan, pay, done.
Yes, I accept Ncash.
I accept Ncash.
I accept Ncash.
Find businesses that accept Ncash with the Nearby Business feature. Visit ncash.com to learn more, download the app, and create your wallet today. It's as easy as scan, pay, done.
New specs, new vision at Seaview Optical. Get single vision clear lenses in frame $299. Bifocal clear lenses in frame $399. Single vision transition lenses in frame just $999. So much more offers in store. Only at Seaview Optical. Affordable eye care for everyone.
Welcome back. An all-round performance from Fatima College earned the Mukarrapo-based school a 33-run win over Naparima College in the secondary school's Intercall T20 on Thursday. The win ensures Fatima's participation in next week's semi-final. Ian Wason has the highlights.
Fatima batted first and got a good start from Aditya Ramdeen, who scored 26, and Isaiah Fernandez, who added 16. Fernandez was the first to go. Matthew Cooper, the wicket-taker.
This one is up in the air, and the catch is taken.
Ramdeen was gone three balls after. Now skipper Joshua Davis was next out in the 11th over, with a score now 55-3. Runs were hard to come by, but Zachary Siwa top scored with 27.
Good shot.
But his innings ended with this ball from Liam Mamchan, who took 3 for 12 as Fatima closed on 108 for 6 from 20 overs. In reply, Stefan Katwaro looked good at the start of the innings, but he edged the wicketkeeper off the bowling of Ramdeen in the 5th over for 8. Alex Gopal fell victim to an accurate throw from the deep to effect a smart run out. Rundle Gopal looked steady for his 17, while Fariz Ali played some shots of his own.
With mid off and mid on up.
But after hitting a 6, he was out the very next ball for 8, and Naparima was in trouble at 37 for 3. That triggered a mini collapse with the wickets of Gopal and Raheem Nelson, and suddenly, Naps were 39 for 5. Things didn't get much better, even as Matthew Cooper got this odd 4, as the wickets kept coming for Fatima as Naparima folded for 75. Giving Fatima the quarterfinal win by 33 runs. There were also wins for Presentation College San Fernando and Presentation College Aguanas, and Hillview College was also victorious. Ian Wason, CNC3 Sport.
Thanks for that, Ian. Time now for a second break.
Ladies, get ready to win up to $5,000 in cash and prizes with Vitabiotics Mother's Day Shop and Win promotion at Pennywise Cosmetics. Purchase any Vitabiotics product and enter for your chance to win. Promotion ends May 16th, 2023. See Facebook for details.
The Premier League on C-Sport just got better. Win your share of up to $15,000 when you play CPIC. Predict the winning teams, final scores, and score difference, and a piece of the pie could be yours. Compete for the title of CPIC champion and put your Premier League knowledge to the test. With millions up for grabs, top the table and take home the cash. Visit csport.win today and log your predictions. C-Sport, the best way to see sports.
New specs, new vision at CV Optical. Get single vision clear lenses in frame $299. Buy focal clear lenses in frame $399. Single vision transition lenses in frame just $999. So much more offers in store. Only at CV Optical. Affordable eye care for everyone.
My parents' generation grew up with Royal Castle from the first restaurant in 1968 when that distinctive, tempting aroma hit the air. Like never before, fried chicken with a special blend of local seasonings and a one-of-a-kind flavor down to the bone. Today, Royal Castle still have that same delicious taste and I love it too. And the kids, they have more to enjoy. For me, the castle is more than just nice food. It's we own, part of me and you, and is the real flavor of TNT.
Have you been delaying taking care of your eyes? You could risk losing sight of those you love the most and even put yourself in harm's way. Don't wait until it's too late. At CVRS, sponsor of Trinidad Eye Hospital, we can help. We offer surgeries for cataracts, retina, and glaucoma with subsidized pricing to suit your budget. See your loved ones clearly every day. Preserve your eyesight. Call us at 235-4834 today.
You've said that to me so many times, that you fell in love with me, that you won't abandon me ever. But then you do something that makes me doubt you all over again. I will start believing in you the day you prove to me that you truly love me.
Don't miss What Life Took From Me. Saturdays and Sundays at 8 p.m., Monday at 9 p.m., Wednesday at 8:30 p.m., Thursday at 9 p.m., and Friday at 8:30 p.m. only on CNC3.
Director of the Pan-American Health Organization has urged Caribbean and other American countries to urgently ramp up routine vaccination programs as the risk of disease outbreaks in the region reaches a 30-year high due to a decline in vaccination coverage. While the Americas was the first region in the world to eliminate polio in 1994 and has historically been a world leader in disease control and elimination, national immunization programs have suffered numerous setbacks over the last decade. And two Indianapolis police officers are recovering after they were wounded in a gun battle that left the suspect dead. Here's more from this report in CNN.
The suspect in Thursday's shooting was under investigation by both the Indianapolis and Lawrence police departments for another shooting before he led police on a chase that ended with the suspect being shot to death by IMPD officers.
How did this person get a hold of this weapon and, to use against not only us, but our community members?
Members of the Indiana Guns Crime Task Force will have to figure that out. It's a coalition of agencies including IMPD, surrounding counties, and the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms.
Are all engaged and they have one mission, to make our community safer and to protect them from people who on a daily basis use firearms against their neighbors.
ATF agents will get the serial number of the gun used in this crime and do an emergency trace to figure out where it came from. The damage caused by this gun was so bad that IMPD Assistant Chief Chris Bailey says the officers were lucky to be alive.
The bullets went through the metal of the car. There's a part of the side of the car that's peeled back. That's how powerful of a weapon those officers are up against.
Let's take a look at the weather forecast for this afternoon, courtesy the Trinidad Tobago Met Office. Partly cloudy and breezy conditions are expected this afternoon with a few brisk to moderate showers. Seas are moderate with waves 2 meters in open waters and below half a meter in sheltered areas. The maximum temperature in Trinidad is 33 degrees Celsius, while Tobago will see a high of 31 degrees Celsius. Well, thank you so much for joining us for a look at this day's developments. So far, we'll have these stories and much, much more in our major newscast at 7 p.m. tonight. So have a very great day.
CNC3.